Good morning, brothers and sisters, and welcome to morning prayer.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Thy health and salvation. All ye who hear, now to his temple draw near. Praise him in glad adoration. Praise him.
Wonderful morning. Let us pray and give God worship for all that He is doing in our lives. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for I put my trust in you. Show me the road that I must walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. We continue in prayer. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Jubilate. O shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good, his loving mercy is forever, his faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And so we hold a moment of silence where we reflect upon those things that we have done that we know was not acceptable to God, or thoughts, or words, or deeds, or disobedience, those things left undone. Let us all bring them to God. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The appointed Psalms for today is Psalms 30 and 32.
Psalm 30. I will exalt you, O Lord, because you have lifted me up and have not let my enemies triumph over me.
O Lord, my God, I cried out to you, and you restored me to health.
You brought me up, O Lord, from the dead. You restored my life as I was going down to the grave.
Sing to the Lord, you servants of his. Give thanks for the remembrance of his holiness.
For his wrath endures but the twinkling of an eye, his favor for a lifetime.
Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning.
While I felt secure, I said, I shall never be disturbed. You, Lord, with your favor, made me as strong as the mountains.
Then you hid your face, and I was filled with fear.
I cried to you, O Lord. I pleaded with the Lord, saying,
what profit is there in my blood if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you or declare your faithfulness?
Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper.
You have turned my wailing into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy.
Therefore, my heart sings to you without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give you thanks forever.
Psalm 32. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven, and whose sin is put away.
Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, and in whose spirit there is no guile.
While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long.
For your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up as in the heat of summer.
Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not conceal my guilt.
I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord. Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin.
Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in the time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them.
You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eyes.
Do not be like horse or mule, which have no understanding, which must be fitted with bit and bridle, or else they will not stay near you.
Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord.
Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Shout for joy, all who are true of heart.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Joshua, chapter 6, verses 1 to 14. Now Jericho was shut up inside and out because of the Israelites. No one came out, and no one went in. The Lord said to Joshua, "See, I have handed Jericho over to you, along with its king and soldiers. You shall march around the city, all the warriors circling the city once. Thus you shall do for 6 days, with seven priests bearing seven trumpets of ram's horns before the ark. On the seventh day, you shall march around the city seven times, the priests blowing the trumpets. When they make a long blast with the ram's horn, as soon as you hear the sound of the trumpet, then all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city will fall down flat, and all the people shall charge straight ahead." So Joshua, son of Nun, summoned the priests and said to them, "Take up the Ark of the Covenant, and have seven priests carry seven trumpets of ram's horns in front of the Ark of the Lord." To the people he said, "Go forward and march around the city. Have the armed men pass on before the Ark of the Lord." As Joshua had commanded the people, the seven priests carrying the seven trumpets of ram's horns before the Lord went forward, blowing the trumpets, with the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord following them. And the armed men went before the priests who blew the trumpets. The rear guard came after the Ark, while the trumpets blew continually. To the people, Joshua gave this command, "You shall not shout or let your voice be heard, nor shall you utter a word until the day I tell you to shout. Then you shall shout." So the Ark of the Lord went around the city, circling it once, and they came into the camp and spent the night in the camp. Then Joshua rose early in the morning, and the priests took up the Ark of the Lord, the seven priests carrying the seven trumpets of ram's horns before the Ark of the Lord passed on, blowing the trumpets continually. The armed men went before them, and the rear guard came after the Ark of the Lord while the trumpets blew continually. On the second day, they marched round the city once and then returned to the camp. They did this for 6 days. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Canticle, God's Plan of Salvation. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with all the spiritual blessings of heaven, God chose us in Christ before the world was made to be holy and blameless and to live by his love in his presence. God planned through Jesus Christ to bring us to himself as his children, that we might praise the glory of his grace, his free gift to us in the beloved. In Christ we gain redemption. Through his blood our sins are forgiven. How rich is the grace of God.
A reading from the Word of God written in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 26, verses 26 to 35. While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will never again drink of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." And Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times." Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, the word I want to share with you today is God's word is true. It seems very simple, and you've heard it many times, but our lessons today prove to us that God's word is true. But more than that, how important following his instructions are. We have Joshua in Jericho, and we know this story about how they brought down the walls of Jericho and so on. But what is most important and enlightening for us is that God gave specific instructions to Israel. He said, "March, be quiet. March and be quiet." Of course, there are more intricacies in its instruction, but the thing is, they followed his instruction to the letter. They followed instructions to the sixth day, and he said, "Only make noise when I say to make noise." And they followed what he said, and the walls came down. I mean, if you continue in the story, you will know the walls came down, and the people were astonished by what happened, because you didn't have any war. You didn't have anybody running in with knives and guns and cannons or whatever we might imagine in our heads. But they followed God's instructions. And he said, "When you follow my instruction, you will be triumphant. You will see triumphant results." And we know that his word is true when we fast forward to the gospel reading, where Jesus is telling his disciples, who are adamant, "I will follow you, I will be there with you, I'm at your side, I will never leave you." And you know, I imagine it this way, right? He gives this little chuckle. "You're in denial, you are in denial, because you will deny me before that cock crows three times." And there is Peter, adamant, "No, I wouldn't." And it's amazing, because we ourselves find ourselves, you know, if I ask you, or if we're asked the question, are we disciples? Yes. And do we think that we're following Christ? Yes. And I love God, and I trust God, and God is good, and all of the wonderful statements put together. And then in the middle of struggle or some sort of tragedy or something, we forget who we are. We forget whose we are. And it happens. It happens. The thing about it is, Jesus said to Paul and to Peter and his disciples, you all are going to deny me. And later on, we read that they did. They scattered. Reading says to prove what was said before, the prophecy that went before, that the sheep would be scattered. That's fine. But the point is, God's word was proven to be true. What he said would happen, happened. What he said would happen, happened at Jericho and before the cross. It was true. The most important part for us is to follow God's instructions. Before they were on their way to the Garden of Gethsemane, he left some final instructions when he sat with his disciples. Those 12 representing us today. He says, feed on me. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, of course, as Anglicans, we have the symbolic, physical representation of God's body and blood that we receive every time we enter into the Holy Eucharist. But there is something else that is required of us as individuals. To feed on God, we must believe. To feed on God, we must be obedient. To feed on God, we must get to know who He is. Get to know Him. We can't just be walking around and boasting that we are His disciples when we have never spent any time at His feet. Feeding on God means praying. And prayer comes in different forms. It's not just about crying out to God and listing a whole thing, set of things of what we want. But it means being quiet and listening to His voice. Because prayer is a simple conversation. And when we understand conversation, I speak, you listen. You speak, I listen. And so it requires us to be still, be quiet, to hear God's voice. And it doesn't mean all the time that there must be chatter, but that we can just be quiet and still in God's presence, looking for God in everything, seeing God in each other. Feeding on Him means being obedient to His word, following His commandments, the things that He has asked us to do. And most important things that He has asked us to do is to love Him, which is God, who is God. Love our neighbors. Him to love, our neighbors to love. Just two things. And those two things are very wide and big. But it's two things that we must remember and keep in mind. Loving our neighbor means doing good, means sharing, means reaching out. It means forgiving. God's word is true. Even the psalmist talks about him feeling as though God is not near. But when he cries out, God answers. God promises something to him and he says, God gives in. God says, yes, I will do it for you. And look, it is done. And the psalmist, in the midst of waiting for God's results, feels as though he's a little lost and so on. But then he realizes that it happens. God will come through in His time. But there's something basic that is important to us. We must follow His instructions. Feed on Him in remembrance of what He has done for us. The sacrifice that He has made to save us so that we would find a space, a place in the kingdom that He has gone to prepare for us. Follow God's instructions, for His word is true. Pray, be obedient, believe in Him, trust Him, do what He has asked you to do, respond to each other, love, forgive, and so much more. God loves us and He wants a deep and good, mighty, strong relationship with us. You understand that that is the basis of it. That's how Joshua was able to defeat so many. That's how he won the war at Jericho. Because he had a deep relationship with God. And in being in that deep relationship with God, when God instructed, he was able to follow and lead others into following God. And so they were triumphant. So let us be triumphant. Live a triumphant life by following God's instructions. For his word is true. Amen. Let us continue with the words of the Apostles' Creed as we affirm our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world. For only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O God, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. O Lord, mercifully receive the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may know and understand what things they ought to do, and also may have the grace and power faithfully to accomplish them. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the rest of the past night, and for the gift of a new day, with its opportunities of pleasing you. Grant that we may so pass its hours in the perfect freedom of your service, that at evening we may again give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created, and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in your love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we just pause for a moment where we offer our own petitions to God. We also bring before God in this time of hurricanes and natural disasters, we bring all of those countries and all persons who are affected around the world and who may become affected. We pray that God will give us a sense of responsibility, that we will respond urgently that to the needs of our brothers and sisters around the world and even in our own nation and community. That we are and will always be ready to give and share with those who do not have. Pray also for those who have lost loved ones and those who are sick, especially those who are sick due to cancer and other diseases. Pray for their families and caretakers, that God will be with them, that they will lean and trust in Him, that they will hold on to Him and know that He understands and is with them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all countries around the world as we all try to adjust to some sense of normalcy in our daily living. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so we continue with the prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons, in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful day, everyone. God bless.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He sheds on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a burden we bear, not a sorrow we share, but our toil He doth richly repay. Not a grief nor a loss, not a frown or a cross, but is blessed if we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. What we never can prove, the delights of His love, until all on the altar we lay. For the favor He shows and the joy He bestows are for them who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Then in fellowship sweet, we will sit at His feet, or we'll walk by His side in the way. What He says we will do, where He sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way.